All right, it's been a couple days, so just a reminder, we do need to have both the threads threaded out the back. We went over in other videos, we went over to bobbin threading, we went over to top end threading. So I've already got the white thread in here, which is easy to see against the blue material, dark blue material, for errors and just while I'm learning. In this case right now, I do need to feed my thread. Now, before I touch anything, by the way, I'm going to go up onto the touch screen right here, and I should have up in my touch screen, I should be able to get back to, I'm backing out of the pattern right now, and when we get back out here, the second one over right here, okay, it's a little difficult to see in the dark right now, but I'll do a separate one for the, what's on this going on with this panel up close, but the second button open is a lock button, okay? It kills basically the power for the up down if I'm doing this right. And by the way, everybody should double check everything I'm telling you. If I'm wrong, please let me know so I can correct it. But because this is my very beginning of using this thing. But right now, if I with a lock button on, press this button here for the threader, for the needle, the thread up and down, it's not moving, right? If I go on to the other side here and I tried to make the system work, it's not gonna go, it's not gonna move because we're in lock mode over on the screen, right? So it's a second button. First button is a return button, second one is a lock button. The lock button's important. Okay, so I took the lock off. We now need to get this, let's see where we are here with our, take that back on, put it back on again. If I'm gonna put my fingers in there, I want that on. It looks like the thread right now is broken from the top, okay? So I'm just going to disconnect it. This would be very difficult to be able to see, but there is thread right now between my fingers, okay? I'm going to feed. Once you get this down pat, everything else is already set up, right? All I'm doing is setting up for another run, all right? I've already done a run before and I just left it the way it was. I go to number six, which is a little hook. I'm sorry, number six, which is back behind. It's a little tiny hook. And it's even hard to see the six, but if you took your thumb and put it on the thread and press straight back, you'd see a little notch and a number six. Put it in a notch, keeping a little bit of tension on it so it doesn't come out of the notch. Bring it up through, there's a little holder right here that will bring it through, and around number seven, okay, and up to number eight. Number eight is like an automatic cutter, okay? It's just gonna cut it off. Now, at that point right now, what we're looking to do is we're looking for the this switch right here on the side. This is switch right here, let me see if I can get my arm out of the way, is going to bring down that automatic setting, and it's gonna thread that needle. Now, the needle does need to be up in the upright position. There's a lever underneath here, which controls that on each side. I'm gonna leave it up. Now this is a manual thing, it's not nothing electric, all right? It just feeds down and in. Now, I'm not kidding you when I say the first time I did it, it might have taken me three times, four times. After you kind of get like a feel for the thing going down, and in one stroke right there, there's my thread, and it's through the needle. Pretty cool. If you got big fingers, you're probably not gonna, all thumbs, let's put it that way. It's probably gonna be a little difficult to thread that needle here, that feature is gonna do it for you. Now, after we do the top threading through the needle and we put an inch or two out the back, we're then gonna do the bottom, okay? And to feed the bottom up through, we have to turn off our safety switch here. And then we have to hit this button. It's the second button over. It looks like a little needle with a line at the bottom, okay? We're gonna hit that button two times. One, two. Now, the second time I hit it, it's amazing how this thing works. And like, you know, the first time again, everything was a mystery. It was probably doing it right the first time. I probably just didn't know it. All right. If I'm looking right now, I now have a thread right here. And as I pull that thread up, what I'm going to do, I was doing it the other night, I'm going to use my scissors that come with it. You could probably use something else this small. And I'm gonna lock my screen again, okay? So I'm reaching under the needle. The needle can't get me. I'm gonna take the scissors and I'm just gonna run it like this, because what I'm looking to do is I'm looking to catch the thread that's already threaded through the front, but you can see it's down in the bottom, And what it does is it catches, I'm going to keep a little tension on the top right there, it catches the bottom, if everything went well for the bobbin. Now, in this case here, I do need to make sure that my top thread is above that little footer. Okay? So I'm going to feed that back out, and out the back. That gives me my couple inches out the back. And then, if I look really careful down at the bottom, there it's just a little piece, and that's why you need the machine turned off while you're doing this, because you're reaching in right under the needle. There's the bottom bobbin thread. As I pull it out, I can see the bobbin spinning easily, okay? I feed that out the back. So that's my top and my bottom, okay? So the top is through the needle, the bottom is through the bobbin. We're ready to go. All right, I'm going to take my hoop and the excess material, we're going to put it all to this side out of the way. I know it won't be this convenient later on when I'm doing actual embroidery in specific places, but as I showed you, I just cut it, okay, to make room. Now the little leg there is up and out of the way. I can lift it a little bit if I need it. I'm going to feed my material down. Just walk it so that it goes up over top of it. I want all of my material out, because this is what got caught on me before. The material underneath here is what got caught in the pattern, in the embroidery. I want it all out and tucked up inside, or out of the way if you would. And then these little notches right here are going to fit right into the notches on the machine. And I'm going to press them down until they click. You hear it's a solid click. There's a little metal tab right there. Okay. So that's pretty darn good. Now, the next thing I can do, I'm going to turn my button back on again. I think I can just hit the button right there. We're ready to go with that. And then remember, there was that lever at the back that brings that footer up and down. We have to bring that down. Otherwise, this light will not turn green for us to be able to do actual embroidery. While you're up, it won't work. Okay? So that's going to bring us down to there. Again, I want to make sure this material can move around, has a little bit of playroom. It's not going to get caught on something while it's going. Give me a second. I'm going to set up the embroidery pattern over here. That'll be a separate video, I think, later too. Okay, again, there's a number of buttons to push here, and I think it deserves a close-up view with the video, separate video. If you agree, feel free to put it in comments below for what buttons I'm pushing right now to download this custom pattern. Now, one of my, I don't want to call it unique abilities, but one of my abilities is computers and computer programming. So the digitizing part of this, I might have mentioned in the earlier video, is what got my attention to begin with, okay? So this first pattern is a digitized pattern, my first attempt at digitizing as well as first attempt at embroidering with the machine. So we got a double trouble going, okay? We can see right now the green light is lit up over here. I'll skip the steps of what it took to get to there. We're just going to say we did everything right. We lowered down our footer. We set the pattern in on this side over here correctly. And then when it was ready to go, over here there's a button that says embroider. Press the embroider button. If everything is in play, green light. If say I left the footer up. Oh, let me get it up there. Red light. Okay? Or if there was something over here that wasn't completed, red light. Okay? Which is not going to go, right? For example, I just locked the screen over here. Red light. We got to get past those things to make sure that you're ready to go, okay? Unlock the thing and bring your footer back down. Green light. All right, so once we get the green light right now, I am going to hold this material up a little bit. Just again, I'm in a pretty cluttered area here right now until I get a room cleared out for hopefully being able to do this work downstairs in an old office that I have. That's probably a better use of space for me. And then I will have more room to be able to have things flying around out on tables and not getting caught, if you would, on something else. So, enough said. Let's give it a try. I'm keeping my hands totally free and away from this. Now, again, because when I set this up, I set up the pattern with these back stitching, okay? the back stitching really didn't look very good in my final product over here. It's very probable or possible that I'll need to take that back stitching out. What I'm looking for right now is the pinch. I'm not putting my hand under there. The pinch in the fabric. I want to see the embroidery look like, you know, a finished, you know, I won't say professional, but like a finished product embroidery, not pinched. It's pretty amazing when you look at it like this right now. It doesn't look really like anything but a big mess. These are all the back stitches. Back stitches help fill out the pattern so that, you know, when if it just did back forth, back forth, back forth, and the stitches were, say, this big apart, you would eventually get where you could get some spread. You'd see the material, what's the underlying material under it, and that would, in this case, would be blue. You wouldn't have a consistent. The back stitching is supposed to fill that in a little bit so you don't have that so much with your pattern. I also suspect that I'm going to go through learning curves here with types of thread. I understand polyester, rayon are two of the main ones, and the thicknesses of the thread, okay? It does seem like right now that the thread that I'm using, it's, from what I read, was a pretty standard thread. It appears to be kind of light and thin, so maybe the stabilizer is going to make that look better, or... I won't bore you guys with the whole thing. I'm gonna take this off and we'll let you see what it comes out like. Okay, I think we have a significant difference going here. I'm gonna press the lock button here. So, finish embroidery, yes. I'm gonna hit the lock button. Button will turn red. I'm gonna lift up that footer off of the pattern. I'm going to release, there's a tab right here, the hoop. I'm going to bring the hoop back. Up and under, and notice that even the thread, you know, the machine cuts the thread at the end. That's kind of nice, all right, so we're not fighting with it at the end. And let's take a look at my first attempt at embroidery digitizing. And it's okay to be critical here. I mean, I've never done this before, and I'm gonna have to learn a little bit more. What I think is about as important as anything right now is, let's see, if we can compare it, let's take it out of the hoop. I want to compare it to the one with the other stabilizer to see how the stabilizer did. Loosening the hoop just to take so I'm not putting too much pressure on the fabric and the material. I'm releasing it, pulling it apart. Top piece is going away from behind. There's what your stabilizer looks like from being inside the hoop. The front, all right. At a distance, by the way, not horrible. Now, you would still take the scissors and cut away the runners. Right now, you may be focusing on these little guys right here. And they're meant to be cut out. So I guess the takeaway from this for the minute anyway is it's not really horrible for the difference. I would say it was easier to be able to hoop this one right here than it was to be able to use the tear away on the other side. We'll give it some time and some practice, but something tells me that if it came down to it, I could use a tear away as a backup plan if I needed to do it, even with a t-shirt, all right? Now, when you talk about long-term, here's a reason you still would want to go with the cutaway when you wash it, all right? These threads here, if they shrink or in the dryer, if they go to shrink or whatever, this is going to hold up, okay? Because this stays with the pattern. It doesn't come away. You just basically take a pair of scissors and cut. That's why they call it a cutaway. And cut out around it. So your end... product. Looks something like that from behind. Okay, front. See if you can see the tearaway. There's nothing around it, right? This one still has the around it. This is gonna hold up with washing and not get messed up. This one we anticipate would begin to, especially I think the drying, if I had to guess right now, especially with the polyester, that's plastic, right? So if it gets in heat and it gets around a hot dryer, now these runners right here, they would all be cut off, but frankly I'm not going to take the effort, right? But you know what, not horrible, not great, all right, but hey, I'm not expecting this thing a miracle first time around. I hope this is helpful for you to get a better idea of stabilizers, what my experience is like here kicking off out of the gates. And if you like what you've seen so far, I know I've gotten a couple nice comments from folks, feel free to like us here, like me here at YouTube with this Brother SE600. And I'll take a couple minutes as I'm progressing through this to add more videos up there so that folks can learn a little bit more about this machine. The SE600, by the way, is effectively, so I understand, the same as the SE625. 625 just has, I think, some more patterns, a little flashier look to the outside of it. You know, it's truly just a matter of what you kind of like, I think, at that point, if it makes any sense to you. So again, thanks for bearing with me here. I hope this, anything of this video helps as you move through your learning curve with your Brother machine or any embroidery machine if you're watching the video. Okay, once again, signing off. I look forward to coming back, maybe talking about this panel on the next time. Tell me if you think that would be helpful. All right, in the comments below. Thank you.